What is going on, guys? It is your boy DFastX, and I'm back with another movie review, and this is my review on Oppenheimer. Forward to the video. If you're here to see more exciting videos from new to this channel, smash the subscribe button, hit the bell icon, and drop a like. Let's start right to it. So I watched this film on the big IMAX screen, which is really is worth to watch. And all I've got to say, guys, this has officially become my movie of the year. Oppenheimer was absolutely incredible. Guys, I gotta say this. I was amazed with Oppenheimer. Christopher Nolan just proves us all why he is still one of the best filmmakers till this day. From Interstellar, The Dark Knight Trilogy, Inception, Tenet, Christopher Nolan just nails his work. Guys, I never felt this scared after leaving the cinema. Because you wouldn't leave this out. After I watched this film, my hands were literally were shaking. Like, I could not believe the story of this movie. Because this story is obviously based on is a true story. This is based on J. Robert Oppenheimer, who is the father of the atomic bomb during the World War II times. Because he found out that the Nazis were building a bomb, and they're kind of way ahead of them, and the Americans are trying to kind of like catch up to them. So what J. Robert Oppenheimer was trying to do was try to test out this atomic bomb, will it work and stuff, to defeat the Nazis and stuff. And also the other war that's happening as well in Japan. And when you watch this movie, I just want to say that it's really just breathtaking. It's just really is breathtaking when you watch this film and stuff. Because it's just every moment of this film is absolutely amazing and stuff. You know, and like Christopher Nolan, like he said that in his movies he actually never uses CGI at all. Like in this one, there's zero CGI. He uses some kind of like a different. I don't know what it's called again now, but he kind of uses like a different kind of technology to create this. And the way he shot this, he shot the atomic bomb as well, it was absolutely beautiful. Like, it was like, and like when you watch it at the big IMAX, it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing and stuff. And even the sound as well of the atomic bomb, like you hear, like it goes silent, basically you hear a boom, a huge like blast. It's like, oh my God, it is literally breathtaking, and you make you like, whoa my God, like, you know. But I absolutely love this film, and you know, watching different films this year and stuff, and like I actually wanted to see Oppenheimer anyways and stuff. And of course I heard the whole thing going on with because the Barbie movie came out at the same time, and people were posting memes called Barbenheimer, which I won't be seeing Barbie, I'm afraid, but maybe I might watch it later on this year. But if I had to compare these films to Barbie, I think a lot of you should go see Oppenheimer than Barbie. Because Oppenheimer, now I know it's 3 hours long, but you have to stay in for the acting, the performances, the cinematography, every bit of the film. You have to stay in for those, because let me tell you this, that Cillian Murphy, get him to the Oscars. Get that man to the Oscars. He needs to get that Oscar next year. I don't care what anyone says. He needs to get to the Oscars, because he was absolutely fantastic, and he's still one of the best actors till this day. Because I've seen him in Peaky Blinders as Thomas Shelby, absolutely fantastic. And for an Irish actor, like, he's absolutely fantastic. His performance as Oppenheimer was incredible. Like, even when he was doing like the scenes that he was doing the physics and stuff of trying to with the atomic bomb and stuff and that. Is amazing to see, because you know that just proves that Cillian Murphy is an outstanding actor. He's just brilliant and stuff. And now, also, Robert Downey Jr. appears in this movie as well, and he needs to get to the Oscars too for Best Supporting Actor, because he was fantastic in this movie, absolutely fantastic and stuff. Now, there's other actors like Florence Pugh and Emily Blunt who don't appear much in it, which is a pity. Would like to see more scenes of Emily Blunt and Florence Pugh, because they're both great actors, like, you know. And I see Florence Pugh in the Marvel movies and other films that I watched as well with her. But I wanted to see more scenes of her, unfortunately, but I just want to say that Oppenheimer is such a great film. And you know, I think that has now become one of my favorite films of all time. It has now entered my list of top favorite films. It's just, I never felt this scared after watching it. It was so breathtaking. It's like, you know, Christopher Nolan just knows what he's doing. He knows what it is, how to be a good filmmaker and stuff. And like, I see this Dark Knight trilogy, and The Dark Knight is one of the best movies of all time. You even have the Joker poster right beside me over there. And you know, it's like, the scenes that he used to, like, they're all real scenes. Like, the, you remember the scene where, the scene where the Batman flips the Joker on the truck, which is a real life scene of, and it was, and even the loudness as well, it was absolutely amazing to hear and stuff. You know, Christopher Nolan just knows how well to use sound and that, really, really good and stuff. Even for this one, like the atomic bomb and stuff. And you know, the famous quote that J. Robert Arbor says, "Now I've become Death, the destroyer of worlds." And Cillian Murphy just proves that. He just proves that to be one of the greatest actors of all time. Acting is amazing, the story is amazing, the plot is absolutely amazing. And I highly recommend all of you, if you're really cinema lovers like me and stuff, highly recommend to go watch Oppenheimer and stuff. And just witness it on the big IMAX screen as much as you can, because it will be out in cinemas hopefully, because if we go back to the standard screen for a while and stuff. But overall, guys, I absolutely enjoyed this film, and I highly, highly recommend all of you to go and see this film and stuff. And no, after watching this, it's now become my movie of the year, and it's now officially become one of my favorite films of all time. It's my Letterboxd official movie list. And overall, guys, I'm giving this movie an absolutely 10 out of 10 and 5 stars. Guys, if you see this right now, go watch it on the big IMAX. It is worth to watch. You're going to love this movie. Everything about this movie is just absolutely fantastic. Cillian Murphy, Robert Downey Jr., get him to the Oscars right now. They need to get those Oscars. They're just absolutely fantastic. And so, and Cillian Murphy, I see him in other stuff, as I said, Peaky Blinders. It's time he needs to get to the Oscars, because he deserves that Oscar for the best acting performance in this movie. So that is my review of Oppenheimer. So I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. I'll be back with my review of Blue Beetle very soon. So stay tuned for more of my video, guys. Smash the subscribe button, click the icon, and drop the likes. And I'll see you all next time. Peace.